Hello, this is Crimson. In this video, I'm actually doing something way different from what I usually do. I'm doing a found objects portrait, and this was a totally crazy and almost unimaginable project for me to do. I've never done something like this. I have not made a collage since second grade. So this is what is going to be going on. I'm taking a bunch of pieces from around my house, whatever I had for my craft bins, cosplay pieces, whatever. I'm smashing it together to make it look like the medic from TF2. And I'm doing this because it is TF2 Jam, and if you don't know what TF2 Jam is, it's done by TF2 Maps. It is a website that does hosting for people to post their custom maps and custom TF2 items and things like that. So the objective of TF2 Jam is to create a TF2 related project in 72 hours. And so since I will not be able to work Sunday, I did it in these 2 days. So I did this I did this overnight, and I saved the next day to put this video together because I knew I'd have trouble with that. But the portrait itself I worked on for about 10 hours. That is 10 consecutive hours. And I did it overnight, and I actually wanted to make the video right after I finished the project, but I was having a ton of trouble because I was trying to find a program to make it with because I use Premiere Pro and I had to cancel that. Sony Vegas is not working. I'm trying to use the trial and it won't work, so I got this program that I'm using now. So hopefully it all turns out good. And in the portrait, you'll see I'm just mishmashing all kinds of items, just trying to get the shape of the medic, kind of almost like illusion art. You'll see found objects artists do a lot of sculptures that are single perspective pieces, as in you can only look at it from one angle for it to be coherent. Other versions are like mine, where it's on a flat board or a canvas or surface. I did mine on foam board. I do have a canvas, but it's not as big as this, and it is also, I don't want to waste my canvas for this. Not that it'd be a waste, it's just canvas are expensive, so, you know. Some of my favorite things about this is the face, is that I had to go back and add a lot of pieces for it to kind of make sense in my head and look like the medic. I really like the eyes and the glasses. I wish I would have changed the eyebrows a little bit, because he almost looks a little sad, and I wanted him to, you know, medic fierce and strong, and I wanted him to look like that, but it didn't come across exactly like that. I still think it looks good, though. One of my other favorite parts is in the right corner. You'll see there's a bit of spiraled wire. That's actually one of those, like, TV adapter things that, like, you use for, I forget what it's called, but like you use it for to connect a DVD player to a TV. So on one end it has a green bit, which I snipped off. Then I put it in the circle and I wrapped it around, which you'll see later, to wrap around the medic call symbol. And then the other end, which has a red bit and a white bit, I actually incorporated that inside of the call symbol. And I really love that for some reason. That's just like, I felt like that was my moment of genius, artistic genius, and yes, I like that a lot. You'll see a lot of things in this. There's a lot of beads. Fun fact, when I was little, I took a beading class, and I actually got my beads confiscated by my parents because I constantly spilled them. You know, this tub of beads, it just goes everywhere. So yeah, I finally had a purpose to use those beads because I haven't touched them in years. So, a lot of jewelry bits, bits of broken jewelry and jewelry I don't wear anymore, a lot of horse pendants, because people just used to get me horse pendants as gifts because I love horses. I used to ride horses, so I had a ton of those. I don't wear them anymore because I don't wear a lot of necklaces, so there's like probably 5 of those on there. Some other pendants you'll see, a lot of things that look like brooches. They're from rings, like the octopus and the poinsettia as his tie, which I love. I had this shiny red material from a graduation decoration, And I put that down, and then I saw the poinsettia, and I was like, this is perfect. This was meant to be the medic's tie, and it worked out very well. And I love that. And also in the background, you'll see I was kind of getting desperate for dark colored and black things to put in the background. I ended up having to cut out bits of ribbon, lots of paper from a bridal magazine, which I have for some reason. You'll see a magnifying glass. I couldn't remember what it's called. I almost called it a compass. That's not what it is. You see a magnifying glass that's like a decorative one. I just glued it on there. There is a fake toy gun that's been spray painted black because we didn't use that, and so I thought it'd be perfect on there. You'll see some other materials. There's like forks. There's a Iron Cross cosplay prop from my Germany cosplay. Just lots of things. Yes. So if you have any questions about like any material on this, of the hundreds of materials, different things I had to put on here, feel free to leave a comment and I will get back to you. I try to incorporate a lot of medic related items into this. I have a lot of feathers in there. There's plastic bullets from like a toy bullet belt that a friend used for a costume. They gave it to me, so I used that. There's like some bird related jewelry. What else is there? There's a lot on there. There's pill bottle caps. There's some wiring from some medical supplies, things like that, or tubing, not wiring. And so yeah, that's basically everything. It's just a whole mishmash mod podge of things I found in my home. I don't think I mentioned this, but I kind of forgot TF2 Jam was a thing, and so I saw a post about it on Reddit last night about 6:30, and I'm not sure how far into it. It was only a couple hours into the TF2 Jam, so I still had quite a bit of time. I think there was, maybe 60? I had to be like 10 hours into it, so I still had quite a bit of time for this kind of project. And yes, this was totally a challenge. Not that my art has a lot of organization to it, but I've never done something of this caliber of messy. Trying to bring in some kind of organized element to the chaos of putting these colors and pieces and bobbles together to make a coherent thing, and I'm quite happy with the result. I think it does look like the medic, especially there's a few angles that look better than others, but the face is probably my favorite part, because you definitely see the eyes and glasses pretty well. I think I might have said that. So I'm gonna stop talking now because I'm definitely rambling. I'm on 4 hours of sleep. I stayed up for 21 hours and I've never stayed up for 24 hours before, and I wanted to do that, but I just went to bed, so yes. But anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, if you have any questions, leave a comment. If you entered TF2 Jam, or if you're going to enter, leave a link in the comments or tell me where I can find it, because I would love to see that. You can find links to my DeviantArt, my Facebook, to my Etsy page in the description below, so if you're interested in that, go ahead and do that. Not sure what else to say. I think that's about everything. So yeah, thanks for watching.
Since the dawn of the fortress, I have been the key to living to see another day again. I stay back in a race, so your blood and scars, so you can once again answer your call to arms. But the lack of might has given life to irrefutable neglect of the one who brings the wounded to their feet and the living to gods. And even so, I always have infavorably stacked odds, but that all ends now. This is where I stand and fight. Beware the blade and needles, watch this flame ignite. I'm ignoring the calls and stowing the medigun. I'll step the first threshold into this great beyond. I've wasted my time, I'm not high behind the strong. I will show red and blue their perception of me is wrong. Underestimation will become their fatal demise. Through ash into new, fear of the medic will arise. My strikes lay true with every solemn advance. This doctor never again will cater to the ambulance. Medics of the world, stand up and rise up. We will conquer reality while their eyes are shut. No longer will the medic be such a victim of the team. It's time to draw the sword and break the many beams. So unshackle yourselves, exploit their obliviency. Drive their idea of the healer into obscurity. Discard their courage, make them abandon hope. Force them once and for all to fear the white lab coat. We've got nothing to lose but the world to gain. So free yourselves from forces driving you insane. No longer will we fuel your fractious side. Never again will you see us doing what Valve designed. You will soon see that the understated are the biggest threat when they're underestimated. To all who smirk, ignore us, I dare you. Cause when you're cornered, there'll be no one to save you. So arm your stickies, reload your gun, because the combat medic revolution has just begun.
Shut up and sit down. sit down. Thank you.
Thank you.